Ja, Skauer.
You're watching the PLC Open Basics video tutorial series. This video shows how to enable the servos using MC Power. Hi, I'm Matt Pelletier. I think it's about time to get the servos energized, so let's do it. I want to illustrate where we're going in the class project for the next few videos. We'll use the existing HMI program as the interface to enable the servos and start positioning, reset faults, stop motion. And each box over here represents a different POU. And so in this video, we're just doing the enable POU. So let's do that right away. Let's create an enable POU and run it in the slow task. Your language can be ladder diagram, and then we'll add MC power. So see if you can follow along with me. I know that we've done this type of thing before in the IEC Basics class. So we'll just insert a new program. Call it enable. Change the language to LD. Now that program exists, but it's not running in any task. So before we forget, let's insert a program instance of enable. Okay. Enable. We can open that up. Now in the edit wizard, remember the PLC open plus lists all of the instructions related to PLC open, and MC power is the core of turning on the servo. So enter that one here. Our axes are all set up, so we can use those. Screw. We had set up screw as an axis ref, and then enable, we can use the variable from the HMI called G enable, and then be sure you choose the right one here, enable screw. You can open up the HMI I POU and see we'll be using this toggle boolean to turn on and off the G enable screw, and that will be our direct control here of MC power. Now what about these other inputs, enable positive, negative, buffer mode? When you don't know what an input is, you right click and choose help, and we always have here a description of the input and output and parameters. So you can see here that enable positive, negative, buffer mode, those are all E extended instructions and they're not supported. They're reserved for future use. So it's safe to leave those disconnected. And this is really the most basic servo on that we could possibly have. So let's download changes and try it out. And in this version of MotionWorks IEC, I don't have the download changes button, but that's no problem. You can go to extras, options, commands, and under compile, debug, are all of the possible buttons. Download changes can be added. As long as I'm in here, I think I'll get rid of the rebuild project, and I never use patch POU. So I can pull those off and click OK, and now you can do download changes. Of course, you could always do online download changes as well. Now I'm used to this button, so put that in there and download changes. I forgot to connect my demo, so let me do that again with Link Manager. You can always check the status down here. I've set this to customized it to always show it in the taskbar. And now I need to log in. If it times out, you can hit enter again and log in. And there we've got it. Get that camera connected. Log into the camera. I usually zoom in a few clicks, and then I like it small here in the corner. So now download changes. Download changes always makes the project. And then attempts to download. I think I'm going to get rid of this message. It's just complaining about that they don't know if it's the same project or not because it can only remember 11 characters of the project name. I will not show this again. All right, project and boot project, or close that resource. I have this set up. Now I like to arrange this so that I can see everything at once. Tile vertically and I'll see this. And go into debug mode. And under online, be sure that toggle boolean is on for the selected worksheet. Now I can turn on input 1 by just clicking on it. And you can see that that turned on MC power. And there's a confirmation of that with this SO1, which is the brake release output by default. So if you have a brake motor, you can connect that to a relay to release the brake. But functionally, it also means that the servo is enabled. So that's it. Servo on, servo off, servo on, servo off. Now, I've not created code yet for the rotary or the virtual, which are being turned on simultaneously by this other input. But that is what I would like to challenge you to do. Create an MC power for the screw, the rotary, and I don't show it here, but also the virtual axis. Let's see if we can get all of those up and running. And you can resume the video to see how I do it. Okay, I'm going to very quickly create servo enable for the other axes. Leave debug mode. And Yaskawa's preferred method of programming is a vertical layout. We'll put the blocks going down because we'll often have ladder rungs out to the left or out to the right or maybe timers or other logic. So we tend to do a more of a vertical block layout. And one shortcut is to simply type the name of the block like I'm doing here. And you can use the enter key to save some time here. So we got rotary, enter. Use the arrow keys to go over to enable. Got G, enable rotary. Line that one up. Come down here, another MC power. Number 3, that'll be virtual. And arrow over to G, enable. C arrow down here to enable virtual. That is the code. I'm still connected. We'll do download changes. Close the resource. Free up some space. Take a look here with window tile. See my blocks on one side. Go to debug mode. Looks like it's already on. Okay, so turn this one on. There's the left, there's the right, and the virtual. Check it for errors. And if you do have an error ID, all you have to do is look at that the code, the error ID code, the number, and then look in the help and scroll down toward the bottom. Every error ID has a description. And if the servo can't turn on, it's usually one of these physical electrical conditions, or it could be that the axisref.axisnum is not properly initialized. That's why we did that first in the previous video. So use the help to troubleshoot any problems. We now have the servos on. And one feature of this YTTS toggle is that this output queue, let me leave debug mode, the output queue is marked retain. Okay, we don't need to stay in here, but that means that this output will be retained even if you have a warm start or power cycle. So back to debug mode, if I stop, here the controller stopped, the servos turn off, and now if I warm start it, see, that output was retained, and so the servos turn right back on. So that's a handy little feature in an attempt to make this input interface a little easier to use. If you do stop and cold start, then of course they're cleared to the initial value, and you have to turn them back on. And now one final feature that is not so much PLC open, but rather hardware-based, is if you look at your global variables, each piece of hardware does have some feedback, and some of them are related to servo on. For example, I can see here that the screw has a servo on input. This is a status input coming back from the servo into the IEC controller. There's also useful information like the power is on, the main circuit power, positioning complete, hardware base block, there's no e-stop on, And we'd mentioned the break output status. This is a way to get that into your program. So all these signals can be used to make a more robust servo on that checks for these conditions before attempting to use the MC power block. So this is success. We have the servos on.